Hi, and welcome to your technique video for the chromatography lab. During this lab, you will learn how to use both thin layer and microcolumn chromatography to separate a mixture into its components. Chromatography is a lab technique that separates components of a mixture based on the concept of intermolecular forces. Intermolecular forces is really just a fancy term used to describe how molecules interact with one another. Many factors can affect the intermolecular forces in a sample, but shape and functional groups are two that we will worry about today. Two notable intermolecular forces are dipole-dipole interactions and hydrogen bonding. In dipole-dipole interactions, the negative pole of one side of a molecule is attracted to the positive side of another molecule. Hydrogen bonding, which is similar to dipole-dipole interactions, is a stronger intermolecular force that involves special functional groups, such as hydroxide groups. The positive pole centered around the hydrogen atom forms an especially strong bond with another molecule's negative pole around either an oxygen, fluorine, or nitrogen atom. London dispersion forces are a third, weaker type of intermolecular force caused by very small instantaneous changes in the electron cloud of a molecule. These allow it to be slightly attracted to other molecules. Each of the dyes used in this lab have different chemical structures that make them attracted to solvents to different degrees. We mentioned that you will be doing two types of chromatography. In all chromatography, there are two phases, a stationary phase and a mobile phase. The stationary phase is, in fact, stationary, and this term refers to a solid coating. The mobile phase can move along the stationary phase. It is much easier to change your mobile phase than your stationary phase if an experiment doesn't appear to be working. In both cases this week, your stationary phase will be silica, and you will be varying your mobile phase to get the best separation possible. Chromatography separates mixtures based on their intermolecular forces between each component of the mixture and the mobile phase or stationary phase. If one of the components is very attracted to the mobile phase and only weakly interacts with the stationary phase, it will remain with the mobile phase longer and travel more rapidly. This means that at the end of the experiment, the spot will not be near where it started. Components with stronger interactions with the stationary phase will move slower. Thus, the spot will be closer to where it started here. After you have completed your thin layer chromatography plates, you will calculate the retention factor, or RF value, for each of the spots on your plate. RF values compare the distance a sample travels to the distance the solvent travels. Here's the formula for retention factor. Manipulating this equation is pretty straightforward since it's a simple fraction. Kat will explain in the technique video how to measure the components of this equation.